Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Ponsonby. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out the center of our galaxy, to boldly go where everyone has gone before.
Hi guys, welcome back to the Humble Gamer channel. I am the Humble Gamer. This is some more of my journey in the Ponsonby in Elite Dangerous. We are now about 8,000 light years away from the center of the galaxy. We're currently in the Kyloarf sector. Current system is Kyloarf XJRE4-7, if you're interested. Just to show you roughly where we are on the map. We're getting closer into the... We're nearly in the galactic cloud core. We started down over here a long time ago now. I think this was... June we started... June we were last back here. But we are now... all the way over here. Right into the galactic core cloud. Now... before we go back to the galaxy map, you'll notice in the bottom right corner that my fuel is absolutely running out. There's a reason for that. It was an experiment to see just how far I could push this ship before I broke my resolve. But also, the thing is, to refuel often you either have to fly a long way within a system or you have to go off the beaten track, so it actually adds time to my journey. So I thought if I can make fuel stops at an absolute premium, I could improve my journey time. Actually, I've done pretty well. I've covered about 1,500 light years already now. So, in this one little session. So what we're going to do is we're going to find a system nearby that is refuelable. And I'm going to probably look at... oh, you're a big white one. That's going backwards, isn't it? Star type G6VAB. I don't know that star type, so we'll jump to there, because I am still an explorer. Let us never forget that. And we're going to refuel and have a chat about things about like tactics as to when I get into the centre. Because the one good thing about travelling towards the centre is you are getting naturally hotter stars all the time. It's not like going towards the outskirts of the galaxy, the outer spiral arms, where you do run out of hot stars and you end up being in a bit of a... you end up having a little bit of trouble trying to get to places, which we'll come to in late in following series as I make my way up to Beagle Point and then eventually come back home. But this one should be fine. It's a Class G, and I'm fairly sure they're fuel scoopable. It's a yellow-white star. That's usually a good sign. Colour is actually quite a good indicator on these games. Oh yeah, this will definitely be fuelable. So what I need to do is I need to make sure I'm high enough up that I can get close enough to it that I can get a decent amount of fuel, but high enough up that I don't actually incur too much damage from the heat sig. So right, we can probably go a little bit closer. Obviously, one thing you can do is engage silent running, but you don't really want to do that. You can also turn off extraneous ship systems, which is something we'll come to again later on in this series as I get towards Sagittarius A. So let's have a look at the system map anyway. What have we got in this system? Anything of massive interest? Well, it's all unexplored, so I might as well scan most of the stellar bodies that I can. We're getting a good rate of fuel. We'll probably be hit up by... you won't see all the refuel, because the refuel is going to be quite a long process, because I have literally emptied my fuel tanks to try and get as far as I could without having to stop. So while that's refueling, is there anything I can... might be able to scan some of these gas... one of these gas giants. Ah, no, 2,500 light years, light seconds. I don't think I'll be able to scan it. It's worth a try, though. I mean, it is behind me, so I'm going to lose refueling ability. Not all of it, but I'm going to lose some of it. Yeah, there we go. It's dropping rapidly as I... No, I can't get to it yet. So what we'll do is we'll refuel first while I talk to you about the plans that we've got coming up in this series. First of all, I still love the fact that you can just look around the ship. And actually, one thing it might be worth doing is if I can drop out of frameshift drive. No, I need to be in frameshift drive to scoop, don't I? Right, well, bugger, that's another mistake I've made. But the thing is, a lot of things need repairing. Particularly the frameshift drive, so if I quickly repair that, we'll then have to come online. One thing we're going to talk about now is silent running, because silent running is going to be increasingly important to me as I make my way close to the centre of the galaxy, because Sagittarius A is a fairly big landmark within the galaxy, as you might expect, being the absolute centre. Excuse the frame rate. But there it is, it's a massive, absolutely supermassive black hole, surrounded by stars. But the thing with Sagittarius A is this. Because so many explorers like me go there, and because most of them forego weapons, I've only just got weapons, remember, and that's only because of what might happen at Sagittarius A, and I had to go back. Lots of mistakes were made by me. There are lots of people there who want to see me burn. They want to blow me up because I'm an easy target. They don't gain anything from it other than they're trolls and like to do stuff like that. So I will be engaging silent running when that happens. Now, to do that, you basically have to turn off all systems that create heat. You don't have to do that, but if you don't, what happens is all around the ship there are heat vents, and when you close the heat vents, if you look on the main scanning disc, you'll see that my heat is currently 47%. It's the little thing on the left of my scanning disc in the centre at the bottom. Once that hits 80%, it's deemed as excessive heat. Once that goes over 100, you start taking damage. Wonderful. So I am now activated. What we're going to do is we're going to... Don't know, that's pointing me at Sagittarius A. No, it's pointing me at the other star, isn't it? Oh, I need to engage my drive, don't I? Idiot. And then once you have engaged silent running, all the heat stays in the ship, which basically means that you are not quite undetectable.
Frameshift drive charging.
But it means it's much more difficult for people to detect you. And we immediately go to zero thrust as we try and fuel back up here on this star. I know, Pistachio, it's exciting, isn't it? All right, boy. He's very excited. I'm going to have to go and give him and Bullwinkle a cuddle later. But the danger with silent running is your ship can overheat quite phenomenal. It's also a good tactic if you're being a smuggler, trying to get stuff into a station that doesn't normally accept those sorts of goods. So what you do is you can turn off a lot of systems. Things that you can turn off include thrusters, the auto-field maintenance unit, all your weapons, the frameshift drive, any weapons, and life support. That takes down all the heat, which basically makes you utterly undetectable. But you will get cold, and you've only got so much time to do stuff in. That is the plan when I reach Sagittarius A, to make sure that I do not get spotted. Because I don't want to get Sagittarius A. First, the main topic is to look at Sagittarius A and to take a scan of it. That is my main aim. Anything other than that, to scan anything around it, I don't think it will be. It's a supermassive black hole. It's probably sucking all the stuff into it. But anything around it is a bonus. Once I've scanned it and had a decent look at it, I am hightailing out of there and we're starting the next leg of our journey, which, while I'm busy scanning this planet, once I've got past Sagittarius A, my next big aim is this. Smootaway JLP D5184. The reason for this is because if you look in a direct line between this and Sagittarius A, Sol is pretty much bang opposite it. Which means that I'm hoping that when I get there I'll find an opposite Earth, or at least in one of the systems around here I shall hopefully find an Earth-like planet on the other side of the galaxy. That is my ultimate aim for next season, and then the season after that I am of course aiming out here. Beagle Point, which is the furthest point out that is reachable on the galaxy map to the north. Now, somewhere around there, I have to get past one of the biggest barriers in the galaxy, which is the Abyss. It is the Abyss is roughly 2,000 or something stupid light years wide, and there are no stars. So you've either got to force your way through it using frameshift enhancements, which involves landing on planets, which we all know I'm not very good at, or it means going round it, which is probably the thing I'm going to do, but it's going to be a very long and tough mission. Someone tried to get round it, I think they had to backtrack about 20,000 or 2,000 light years or something like that. You can find it all on the Elite Dangers wiki, and I recommend that if you play this game, you look at that. And then once I've done this, I shall be heading straight back to Cooper Hub. And then I shall be rejoining human space, and hopefully by that point I will be able to afford an anaconda, which means that hopefully at some point next year I will be flying around in an anaconda with the rest of the guys, causing shit and destroying Thargoids. That's what I want to do. I want to get involved in this Thargoid thing. But at the moment, we are still in the Kylo Arf sector, heading towards Sagittarius A. Now, there are a lot of stars here, obviously, as you can see. We are deep in. Now, we've not got that far to go in comparison. 8,000 light years, as I said. You know, we are making some serious, serious progress here. And I genuinely cannot thank you guys enough for watching this. I know it's not necessarily a big series, because I'm not necessarily a big YouTuber. In fact, I'm in no way a big YouTuber, but it does really mean a lot that you guys are watching this, and we are nearly refueled. So, yeah, I mean, I know this one hasn't been necessarily a big spacey one, but I thought it was worthwhile letting you guys know exactly what the plans are from this point forward. Get to Sagittarius A, survive Sagittarius A, because the thing is, I also don't know what kind of stuff Sagittarius A is going to give me, let alone that's all on top of anything that other people might throw at me. But first, because we are nearly refueled, we're going to... In fact, we are refueled, so let's go and explore some planets. We haven't done a lot of exploring on this. I reckon this is going to be a gas giant, maybe with ammonia, and I'm not so sure, possibly water-based life, though. So that would add to it. So it's another system under my belt that I'm the first to discover, which is always positive. It means that I'm leaving a trail along the galaxy. And once we get out of Sagittarius A, obviously, there's going to be some more neutron star flight all the way to what I'm going to call New Earth, the New Earth system. And then it'll be Beagle Point, which is neutron stars up to a point. And then we kind of stop, because it gets to a point where it goes, we can't find a neutron star. What I'm saying, it's the website down below, which is the Neutron Star Tracker. I can't remember the name of it offhand, but do. I think Spanch. So double check the link in the description below, and you can find your neutron routes all across the galaxy. And you've seen, if you don't know how to do the neutron stuff, either check the wiki or go back to, I think it's episode 5 or 6 of my first series where I do it for the first time. Not long after the Pillars of Eternity, which is an episode called Where Stars Are Made, which I think is episode 4, so I think it must be episode 5. Because that was when I made my decision to speed this up a little bit, otherwise it would take me the better part of a year. Which is going to take anyway. I didn't mean to do that, that's what I wanted to do. Slow myself down. So I'm going to check down below my face now, see what it is. I reckon it's definitely a gas giant, probably class 2? Or class 3 gas giant. Let's see what it says about class 3 gas giants, shall we? Primarily hydrogen and helium atmospheres with distinctive cloud layers, surface temperature is usually range between 350,000 Kelvin and 800 Kelvin. They're primarily blue in colour because of optical scattering in the atmosphere, with the chance of wispy cloud layers from sulfides and chlorides. It's about 1,000 times the size of Earth. Let's get this scan and let's get the hell back on to our journey to the centre of the galaxy. Once we've scanned this, I'm going to assume that might be a similar thing, maybe a 3 or 4? It's blue again, so it might be a class 3. I'm using knowledge to make really bad guesstimates. Class 3 gas giant. Yay, wonderful. Right, now we're going to go back to the neutron star. Here we go. And then next time you see me, hopefully I'll be around about 5,000 light years away from the centre of the galaxy. That would be the ultimate aim. But I've got a lot of travelling to do. As I said, I'm only about 8,000 light years away from it now, so I've got to really do some work to get that far. But we shall call this little pit stop here, so thank you very much for watching. If you are enjoying what you're seeing, please do like and subscribe. Check out the game in the description below. Check out the original Elite Dangerous stuff in the description below. Check out Elite Dangerous Voyage of the Ponsonby Season 1 in the description below. Find out how I got from Cooper's Hub to here. Also check out my Black Sun D&D in the description below, and check out the Neutron Highway mapper in the description below as well. Thank you so much for watching. I will be seeing you very, very soon. Thank you very much. I am me. That was Elite Dangerous. It's the Voyage of the Ponsonby. Back to the centre of the galaxy we go. Goodbye.
Who's that in front of me? So neither of you, unless it... Whoa! Whoa! Whoa, Naz! Whoa! Just shoots past me and goes careering into the...
Oh, hurts.
There's Russ's ship, just there.
Fuck!
Whoa! As Naz takes off some of Russ's shields.
just bounced off him.